This is a Hobbies fretsaw. In fact, these are two fretsaws. The thing that makes these quite unique is the cam on the top of the saw that you can use to tension the blade.
I bought one from a market in Vauxhall and the other from eBay, and they sell roughly around 5 to 10, maybe 15 pounds, depending on condition.
One is an original hobby saw with a maker's mark on the metal, while the other seems to be a clone. The clone is missing a few parts, but the design still works.
This one was missing the tightening screw here. Also happens to be a little bit shorter.
If you were to buy the modern equivalent of these saws, sold to jewellery makers and dovetail enthusiasts, you would be spending quite a lot of money, up to £100 depending on the size.
I think I'm going to take one of these apart and identify the shapes used to actually assemble this and see if I can make one myself.
I'm going to make a clone of the clone. So I am going to dismantle this saw, and I'm going to start by tapping and drilling out the rivets. To file some of the rivets flat as the drill began to slip off.
So this is all the parts for the Hobbies saw, minus one of these, which didn't come with the one that I found in the market. And there should be another one of these, which is in there. I think that's all the parts. I might have misplaced something already. I'm going to flatten all the sections out now so I can trace them and then create some cut lines to follow. So these two should be the same, so there's no point in me drawing both of them out. I might as well take one and then mirror it when I go to scan it in.
I took measurements of the thickness of various parts and later scanned the image into a computer.
And this is going to be the hardest bit to make. I may end up having to redesign these. So those are the parts for the Hobbies coping saw. What I'm going to do now is scan this image in and import it into Fusion 360 and actually trace over the lines to produce a 3D model of the different parts.
I had to calibrate the image by selecting two points and comparing the measurements with that on the paper. I could then begin sketching over the lines and extruding the new plate parts. Here you can see the plates superimposed on the drawing that I imported as a canvas. I'm actually going to export the individual sketches as DXF files, and then import them into ArtCam where I create my toolpaths. You can use Fusion 360 to create toolpaths, but since I know one software already, I'm not going to go down the route of learning another one.
I've got a piece of aluminium from an Apple computer that comes to a point where the material becomes more valuable than the machine, so I might as well use it to make a fretsaw. So I'm just going to cut this out, so I've just got a nice rectangle with not too many raised bits. Okay, so this is about 1.5 mil, so I think we're going to have to double up some parts, especially the actual C kind of...
The frame is called a frame. I don't actually have enough material to double up the frame, so I'm just going to cut one out and see what happens.
Okay, I didn't set a pecking tool path for the initial holes, and I was just trying to go straight through, so I stopped it and edited that tool path, and I'll have another go.
I used a drill tool path with pecking and retraction at 0.2 millimeters to help make the through holes. It's something to do with the geometry of the bit, or maybe the plunge rate is still set too high, but it doesn't like to plunge straight through the material. In case anyone is interested, I'm cutting at a step down of 0.2 millimeters with a 1/8 of an inch bit, at a feed rate of 200 millimeters a minute, a plunge rate of 80 millimeters a minute, and a spindle speed of 15,000 RPM. Of course, if you don't have a CNC machine, you could also use the other type of CNC machine called a printer to produce templates which you could stick onto the material and then cut out.
Okay, it all looks like it's cut out pretty well. I had to redo some of the tool paths just so I could get a little bit further through. You can see there's a little wafer of aluminium left behind in a few places. Obviously, this is not entirely flat. But everything looks pretty good. It's quite late now, so what I'm going to do is basically move the bit back to the origin position. I won't be in for a few days until Saturday, and then I can have a look at this with sort of fresh pair of eyes and check in case I've accidentally missed something out. I haven't gone all the way through for these holes just because it's difficult to actually get the material out with the type of bit I'm using. But that said, I'm really impressed with this so far. Okay, it's Saturday. I'm going to try and finish drilling through the holes, all the different pieces. I've left it several days, and before I left on the Tuesday, I made sure the bit was back on the origin position under there. This is going to be quite a good test to see whether anything on the machine has shifted over several days. It's a bit of a gamble as well, as if it starts to drill anything out in the wrong position, I'm going to have to stop it very quickly.
Yeah, you could possibly get the computer a bit closer.
Satisfying noise.
Yeah.
This does feel a little bit flexible, but I could always reinforce it later. Okay, these are all the components. I've just filed them to get rid of any sharp edges, and I'm going to attach them now with some small machine screws.
Everything came together quite nicely, and the object being made from aluminium looked very sleek.
Now I need to bend this piece of metal here into this shape there. Okay, I think I've just saved it. You can see the tab is in place there as well. A bit tight. I'm going to file these corners here so they're a bit flatter and a bit wider. Okay, I managed to get one on. It doesn't look particularly great. I just have no idea how they would have made that shape without, I guess, making some kind of former and having a big press. It still doesn't feel right. It's not the right shape. And I can't even open the tab here. There should be a gap there where I actually placed the Fretsaw blade. So I think I'm just gonna have to take this off, as I said earlier. Cut some more of these, or think of another solution.
I really struggled with bending the metal into the desired shape. Every time I attempted it, it seemed to get worse. I guess I could have approximated the negative space of one example and CNC'd that out to use as a former, but I was getting a little impatient.
What I've decided to do is just 3D print this instead. So I've modelled it just now in Fusion 360. I've exported it, put it into Repetia host, and I'm just going to print it out and see if it works. Okay, the 3D printed section of this Fretsaw is done. This is the second version. I've had to file out the notches along here so they're a little bit bigger, and the tab, which is this thing here, is a little bit tight still, but it seems to come together okay. So I'm just going to assemble this. Well, the design definitely works.
Yeah.
It's just the material's a bit flimsy. Yeah. I suspected something would go wrong, but this almost looks like a novelty Fretsaw now. And you tension that up, the actual bar flexes. You can see the shape that it turns into. I think what I should have done, or what I should do if I were to carry on with this project, is to take this section up here and that section up there and extend them to follow along the bar, which I could then fix onto on either side, and the added material should help that become more rigid. Interestingly though, the 3D printed parts seem to be holding well. This is only PLA. I'm sure if I did it with ABS, it'd be a little more tougher. Maybe I'll try cut something first as well. Okay, I thought I'd just try put the old back on the saw, and I think it's actually made a difference. Can actually tension this a little bit. So that slipped out there. Ah, the 3D printed part broke. Damn it.
Some good mileage out of it though.
Yeah, it lasted half an hour. You know.
Yeah, that's a good proportion of the amount of time you spend.
If I can work out how to make these sections out of aluminium, obviously it would be a lot more durable.
Anyway, this video has come to a natural end. I might come back to this project in the future, or not. Only time will tell. But what I'd like to do is make the files available so that someone else with a little more time and skill at bending metal could have a go at making a clone of the clone. So the link to those will be in the description. As usual, thanks again for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.